Hey guys, how are you? So today I am so super excited because I am going to tell you about this collab that I'm going to do. And it's my first collab here on YouTube, but it's with a person that I have been following forever, which is Meg Bernardo. I'll put her name right here. And yeah, she basically has a channel on makeup and all kinds of things. And I just really like her channel. And I've been following her for a long time. I like the way that she does reviews. And so we just recently found out that we kind of follow each other. So we decided to do a collab. And we decided to do it on our favorite drugstore products for our skin tone. So for me, that's a medium tone with yellow undertones. So yeah, let's begin, and don't forget to check out Meg's channel, okay? So the first thing that I wanted to mention was obviously foundations. And foundations, you guys know that are my absolute favorite. They are the thing that I'm like all about, all passionate about. I have done gazillion reviews on foundations. And I will tell you the ones that I think pull a little bit more yellow and that are medium tone that I think are good foundations. Now, granted, foundations are one of those things that have gone through a huge transition recently in the drugstore. Before, in the drugstore, foundations, like I would say 80% of the foundations almost always pulled way more cool toned, pinkish, reddish undertones. Most recently, in the past, I don't know, 5-6 years, foundations have like increasingly been adding more warmer tones to their foundations. So with that being said, here are my favorites. So the first one that I think, if you take anything from this video, take this foundation. This is the L'Oreal True Match, and this is in the color W4 Natural Beige. And this is a foundation that, I mean, it's amazing on its own. You guys can go see my review on it, but it also, this color in particular, pulls very yellow. And I find that I don't have to do any correcting with any type of product to make sure that this is as yellow as my, you know, neck and décolleté. So I really love this foundation. I think it's amazing. The other one that I wanted to mention was this Maybelline Dream Smooth Mousse. And this is in the color 240 Natural Beige as well. And this one, although it's looking kind of beige on the video, it is kind of beige, but it also pulls a little bit more yellow. So this one is a little bit darker though. So this one I would use during the summer, but I still think it's a really great foundation and it pulls more yellow than nothing. The next one I wanted to mention was from Neutrogena. And actually I like this one and the other one that is called the Healthy Skin. I like them both. Both of them are in the color 60 Beige. And this one in particular pulls very yellow, which I was very surprised. I didn't have to do any type of correcting. It is awesome. And yeah, it is also a great foundation. You guys can go see my review on it. I have reviews on all of these foundations. And finally is my most recent favorite foundation, and I think it's my holy grail foundation of all time over my Derma Blend, over pretty much any foundation that I have. And this is the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte. I have it in the color 104 Golden Beige, okay? While this isn't as yellow as, let's say, the 60 Beige from Neutrogena, this pulls very yellow. And again, it's an amazing foundation. And I like the color a lot. Although this one I would say is probably the one that pulls least yellow, but is still warm enough. Okay, so those are my four favorite foundations. Now let's talk about concealers. And I have two concealers that I like for my under eye area. And for me, my under eye area is very brown. So this is gonna change depending on what kind of dark circles you have, but mine are very brown, and for me what cancels it the most is yellow. And yellow not only covers for me but also gives me tons of brightness. So my two favorite ones are this one from Physicians Formula from the Youthwear line. This is in the color light and yellow, and I only use the yellow one. It is extremely yellow, it is extremely bright, and although it doesn't have the best coverage, it highlights like nobody's business. This one is a Maybelline Age Rewind. I have talked about this so many times in my channel. It's kind of ridiculous, but this is an amazing concealer. I have it in the color Neutralizer. And again, this pulls very yellow, but it's also extremely light and very brightening. So it has everything. Coverage, brightening, everything. Now for the rest of my face, there are three products that I think are yellow enough. So this one is the Glamouflage, which tends to pull a little bit more yellow, but it's more beige, but it still has, it's still very warm. And again, this is in the color medium. The Glamouflage concealer, there's one thing about bad about this concealer, and it's the fact that it is like, it makes me break out instantly. It's quite ridiculous. I cannot use this for the life of me. I've tried so many times, but every single time I break out completely out of this. So with that aside, there is no concealer that I have that has as much coverage as this one does. It's just ridiculous. It lasts for a very long time. And yeah, it's a really extremely good concealer, and it's extremely inexpensive. The other one that I love is this Revlon Age Defying Targeted Dark Spot Concealer Treatment. And I have it in the color medium as well. And this one, it is extremely thick. It is extremely pigmented. But it's also very yellow undertone. Like, again, it's base beige, but pulls very warm. So, love this one for my skin tone. Okay, so for powders, there are four that I'm going to mention. And the first one that I want to talk about is, okay, my oldest love. And this is the Milani, the Multitasker Face Powder. And this is in the color 04 Light Tan, okay? Light Tan. And is this one right here. This powder is extremely, extremely pigmented, okay? It can be a little bit heavy, so you have to be careful on application. But if you can pull it off, if you can do it right, this powder is going to give you enough coverage, and it's going to, like, again, it's like a base beige, but it pulls very yellow. So, amazing powder. I love it so much, and it's so inexpensive. This one right here is the L'Oreal True Match powder. I have it in the color W4.5. This is like yellow in a powder, okay? This is awesomeness. It is great. It's not my favorite powder, though. So it's more like for color correcting than anything else. To make sure that even if I have a very beigey kind of foundation on, this one will make it a lot more warm without using too much. So there's that. And let's see. L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte. This one, I have it in the color 300 Nude Beige. This one, it is also very yellow. Again, not my favorite powder, but it does amazing color correcting. Although not as good as the L'Oreal. So this one, for example, like if you swatch it, it pulls more, like it looks more beige than anything, than the L'Oreal. So to keep that in mind, but it's still very yellow, more yellow than most. Finally, my favorite thing of all time, you guys, this is the second thing that I'm going to recommend go out and get right now because it is the best thing ever in the world, is the NYX Stay Matte But Not Flat Foundation. It's actually a powder foundation, but I don't use it just like that. But this is a color. I have it in the color 07 Warm Beige. And this stuff is also extremely yellow, guys. If you have very yellow undertone, you need this in your life. Again, amazing color correcting. If you have almost no imperfection, or if you have little imperfections, this foundation is gonna be, this powder is gonna be enough for you without even using liquid foundation. It has amazing coverage. It looks so natural on the skin. This is like the best powder ever in the world. For bronzers, I have three that I really like. We use bronzers for contouring and for like warming up of the face, giving us a little bit of a glow if that's what you're into. And my favorite, one of my favorite bronzers is this one from Hard Candy, which is number 131, which is Hula Hula. I like to use this for contouring as well as everywhere in the face. Yeah, I mean, I tend to prefer using contouring with grayish, more cooler tone browns, but in the summer, I can tell you that that is not probably something that I'm going to continue. I will probably go back to the more cool, but still bronzy kind of shade. So anyway, I can tell you that I contoured with this for a long time and it was perfectly fine. So there's that. And there is this one, which I actually really like for contouring. This one is the Physicians Formula Bronze Booster in the color medium to dark. And is this one right here. I love, love, love this one for contouring, guys. It's amazing. It's an awesome powder. And finally, I wanted to mention this one. This one is extremely warm, okay? But for bronzing the skin, it's so beautiful. The powder is an amazing quality. It does have a little bit of shimmer, but it's nothing that really translates. So, awesomeness there. I'm only going to mention one highlighter because you guys know, again, I don't use highlighters. I have oily skin. I have texture. So, highlighters are a no-no for me. But if I do use one, I will use this one. This is the Wet n Wild Color Icon in Reserve Your Cabana. It is this one right here. It is awesomeness. You guys have heard me talk about this so much, but there is something in this powder. Like, there is zero shimmer, glitter, or anything. Zero pearlescence, but it still highlights. I don't even know what's going on. Now let's talk about blushes. Blushes are like my obsession. I have gazillion blushes, and I really had to make sure to narrow it down for you, okay? So I will tell you my two favorite brands and some of the colors in it. These are the L'Oreal True Match blushes, and I have three of them. I have a lot more. Well, I have two more, but I have three that I'm going to mention right now. And these are all from the Warm line. I think one is from the Neutral, actually. Yeah. But anyway. So there's these three colors, and I really don't know how to describe these colors. I would say they're like bronzy blushes. This one pulls a little bit more pink. This one pulls a little bit more, I don't know. You guys can figure it out, but there's these three. This one right here is called Apricot Kiss. This one right here is Subtle Sable. And this one right here is Barely Blushing, okay? So these bronzy pinky shades, I feel like look so great with our skin tone. It's ridiculous. Like, I feel they look so natural, but it gives it such warmth to the face, such radiance, and I love them so much. The others that I'm going to mention are the Jordana ones. And I have more that I have depotted, but these two I got recently, and I feel they look really good for our skin tone. So this one is Touch of Pink. These ones are only $2.49, guys. $2.49. It's quite amazing. So this is Touch of Pink. It's a little bit more of a corally color, more warm than pink, but it's still amazing. This one is called Coral Sandy Beach. Again, beautiful, beautiful color. It's like a pink, but pulls very warm. And it has like micro glitter that is gold. So there's that. So those two brands of blushes are my ultimate favorite. I feel like they are both extremely pigmented, extremely easy to blend, and they last for a very long time. Okay, let's talk eyebrows. Eyebrows are a very personal thing. Everybody does them differently. In my opinion, if you have brown hair like me, if you have skin like me, you probably should go for a cooler brown. It is against almost anything that I would say because I always go towards the warmer colors, but for your eyebrows, it is very important that you go more of a cooler tone. The reason I say that is because usually, like, if you go for a warmer tone, it's gonna look very reddish. And reddish does not look nice. It doesn't look natural, especially if you have this kind of color. Like, if your hair is red or whatever, yeah, but other than that, there's no way that a reddish brown is gonna work for you. So make sure that you always go for a cooler undertone brown. I have several things for you to try. The first thing, if you guys like powder, you know, for your eyebrows, I really like this one from the, it's actually an eyeshadow from the Sonia Kashuk Eyes on Neutral palette, and is this one right here. This one is an amazing match for me, and it is cool, it is dark, but not too deep. That is just going to look weird. So there's that if you guys like to use powder. If you guys like to use gel or like stuff like that, this one is one that I've tried and I actually have a review on it. This is the NYX Eyebrow Gel. I have it in the color Brunette. It works perfectly fine. It is what I'm wearing on my eyebrows right now. And watch my review because this one has a very particular application method, but it works extremely well. And finally, this one is from Essence, if you guys are into pencils. And this one is from Essence again. It is the Eyebrow Designer. It is extremely pigmented and it works really well. So there's that. Now, let's talk about eyeshadows. Okay, so I feel like everybody in my skin tone, or really any kind of skin tone, would be great with neutral shades, warmer or cooler. I feel I can totally pull off like a cooler eyeshadow look without any problem. So I feel like your eyes are different than like what you put on your face, but for your eyes, I'd go with anything. I feel like obviously for brown eyes, obviously neutrals, but what is it? Purples and greens look amazing. I love the way, I feel like every time I wear a purple or a green, my eyes just look brighter. Like they kind of pop more. Okay, so I have also four palettes that I wanted to mention to you. One is the Wet n Wild Fergie eyeshadow palette. And this one is in the color Desert Festival, okay? Okay, so again, coppery shades are other colors that I feel look so good. Orangey colors, warmer. This is just like my kind of thing. Anyway, this one has amazing colors. It has an orange. It has a pale shimmery orange. It has a like a black brown that has shimmers, but they don't transfer. They have a matte brown, and they have a color that is supposedly for highlighting, but I don't use it because it actually it doesn't have shimmer. Like it's pearlescent. But anyway, this palette, it is so amazing. It is so inexpensive. The colors are ridiculously good. And they blend really nicely. They're very pigmented and they last for a very long time. The other one that I was going to mention was this one by Sonia Kashuk. If this is just a palette that anybody should have. It is amazing. It is kind of like more expensive than what we usually see from the drugstore, but it's still so, so, so good. We have cool tones here, we have warmer tones, we have everything from like white to black. It's just everything there, and they are extremely good quality. So even though it is a steep price, it totally is worth it, I'm telling you. The other two that I'm going to mention are these two. This one is from Wet n Wild, this one is from Black Radiance. And they look exactly the same. They are exactly the same, but they're just from two different brands. So this one is with the purple colors in it. This one is Petal Pusher. Okay. So the thing with, I bet you guys have talked about, have seen about Wet n Wild eyeshadows, especially these palettes here with the eight colors. Awesomeness. They are 100% pigmentation. They blend like a dream. They're just awesomeness. And they have a really great color variety. Petal Pusher, awesome, awesome palette to have. This one is by the brand Black Radiance. And you can find this pretty much anywhere also. You can find it at Walmart. You can find it in some grocery stores. You can find it at Sally's. So extremely inexpensive. These are like $5 each. This one specifically is in the color Urban Jungle, and it has beautiful greens and blacks and this weird yellow that I have never used in my life, but there's that if you're interested in it. But these colors are the exact same quality, buttery, pigmented, amazingness. So green and purple plus neutrals. You got it there. For eyeliners, I believe the same applies. Neutrals, browns, blacks, always, always, always. And I'm not too much of to use like a color eyeliner, but if I did, it would be green, okay? Maybe purple, but mostly green. And so I will tell you my two favorite green eyeliners. But I'm also going to tell you it's more about the brand than it is about the color. You can experiment with pretty much any color, except I haven't used silver or teal for my eyeliner, but you can go anywhere. But green is like my favorite for eyeliners, and besides black and brown, and these two are my favorites. So I got this one from Jordana, which is the sea green. This one is their retractable eyeliner. I think these are only like $1.50, maybe less, maybe 99 cents. They're amazing. They're a little bit drier though, so it's not gonna tug on your skin, but you are going to have to work a little bit more than you're going to have to do with this other one that I'm going to talk about. And this is the Jordana 12 Hour Made to Last Liquid Eyeliner Pencil. And this stuff is hardcore. It's only $2.99, so it's a lot more expensive than the other one, but it is so totally worth it. This one is extremely comparable to me, in my opinion, to the Urban Decay eyeliners. And if anything, I feel like this one has a softer application. Granted, I only have black Urban Decay eyeliners, but I tend to like have to work on them a little bit more. This one, maybe because it's like a liquid eyeliner pencil, it's different. But either way, this is so soft. It works amazing for blending or applying it neat or on your waterline. It stays amazing on the waterline, and so it like where you put it, it stays until you take it off. Like it stays the same. It won't move. So for $2.99, I think this is better than obviously my Urban Decay, but even it is exactly the same as the Milani Liquify. And exactly the same, or maybe even a little bit better than the Rimmel Scandalize eyeliners. So this one is just amazing. There's absolutely nothing to say about this. Get the whole collection and you'll be totally happy. You won't waste your money on these eyeliners. Now let's talk about lips. Lips are another thing that I have kind of evolved to in the past year and a half or 2 years. And I have gathered quite a bit. And I don't know, my tastes are pretty whatever you like. I think us in the medium tone are lucky in the sense that we get to use pretty much anything and pretty much anything will be good. I've never tried, and I don't know what to think about neon trends, but you know, whatever floats your boat. Either way, I will tell you what I think, in my opinion, works best for my skin tone. I feel like oranges are awesomeness. Corals, awesomeness. Reds, I think this is, we are just so lucky. I feel like we can pull off a cool red, so like a blue red or a warm red, kind of like an orangey red. And we can pull off like a neutral, true red, and we'll be perfectly fine. It's gonna look pretty, it's not gonna wash us out, and it's just gonna be amazing. So lucky there too. For pinks, I would say for pinks, I tend to prefer warmer pinks. If I use a cooler pink, it sometimes tends to like wash me out, make me look like pale or like, I don't know. So cooler pinks are not my favorite, but I still, you know, wear them. And this is more of a preference than actually like the way it looks, because I've seen people with medium skin tones pull off like a fuchsia and it works amazing for them. I don't like them too much because I'm not into like that bright of a color, except I use orange, right? Those are my like favorite colors. I feel like browns don't look good on us for some reason. Like it just doesn't work out. Like it makes me look weird. So what I have decided to do is show you kind of like my favorite lipsticks out there, like collections of lipsticks, and then you can choose pretty much any color in the range within the ones that I told you about, and you'll be completely fine. So you know what I'm saying? So let me give you an example. So these are the Smoochies from CoverGirl. These are so inexpensive. They are extremely easy to wear. They're not lipsticks. They're like lip balms, but highly, highly pigmented. And they're amazing. They have true color and they're awesome. I have one in like pink or like a mauve-y color. I have one in orange. I have one in bright pink and I have one in red and I have other ones. They're all amazing. They're all extremely easy to wear. Those are the kinds of lipsticks that you don't need a mirror to put on. So there's that. Amazing. I have them all in it. I would say my favorite lipsticks of all time, even though I've tried a lot more, I've liked and loved a lot more, these are like my true favorite lipsticks in the drugstore. These are the Revlon Just Bitten Balms, and I have gazillions of them. I mean, these are just a few of the ones that I have. These, for some reason, are all of my kind of reddish corally tones, but I have these in all kinds of colors. But I can tell you that I love the, I have from the original line, I have from the matte, and I have from the lacquer line. And I have oranges, I have reds, I have corals, I have pinks, I have everything of those, every one of those colors. I will tell you though, the only colors that I feel I don't do good with are brown, and forgot to tell you, the nude colors, like the ones that are very pale, kind of like erasing your lips kind of nude. To me, it just washes me out. It makes me look so pale and dead. No matter how much I put up here, it just does not look good at all. So, but there are really good, like your lips, but better, or even like nudie type of lipsticks that I like, but not from this brand. Definitely. You're not going to find those here. So yeah, but these are so pigmented, so easy to wear. They leave a stain. They last for a long time, and they taste minty, which is the thing that puts them above my next product. These ones are the matte lipsticks from Maybelline that came out recently. And I have three colors that I absolutely love. I have Siren and Scarlet, which is a red, Lust and Blush, which is a pink, and Touch of Spice. Now, Touch of Spice is a very weird color. I don't even know how to describe it. I don't know if it's a pink, mauve, red. I think right now it's looking mauvey to me, but this one looks, oh my, like you can tell right there, like my hand looks pretty, like it's a good contrast, and it's like my favorite color, and these lipsticks are amazing as well. They last for a long time. I have a review, go watch it. For your lips but better kind of thing, there's two that I absolutely love. There's more, I mean, I love a lot, but I think these two are like perfect. Now, lips are another thing that are very personal. They're very like individual thing, because you can have very dark skin or like medium tone skin and have very reddish lips, have very purplish lips, have very browny lips. My lips are tend to be more browny than anything, but they don't have a lot of pigmentation in them. They're like pale brown. They're like not interesting color. So depending on that, you know, this may change, but I found that my perfect your lips but better things are these two. This one is the NYX Butter Lip Balm in the color brownie. And this one looks so freaking natural in my lips. It's amazing. Amazingness. Amazing. I feel like this is my lip color enhanced, okay? It is very matte. It is not glossy at all. It is not a balm to me. It's not like a chapstick that is going to give you moisture and all that stuff. No. It's just a normal, like, kind of soft lipstick. The other one that I absolutely love is this Revlon lip butter in the color Pink Truffle. Again, this is your lips, my lips, but better 100 times. And not only that, it is so creamy, amazing. I mean, you guys know all about the lip butters, right? Yeah, guys, I think that is it. I think I like flew through that, didn't I? Anyway, I hope you guys liked it. I hope it was useful. And make sure to check out Meg's channel. And I will see you in the next one, okay? Bye-bye. Anything else. But I still like it. I don't have any problems with that. One of my favorite things about this concealer is that it sets really nicely. It sets to a like semi-